How's it going, folks? It's Rob here. Had a couple of things crop up over the last couple of weeks and I haven't been able to get out to the patch much, so I thought what I'd do is I'd give you a bit of a look at a few things that I find interesting and share them with you, and I might be able to upload a soup clip this weekend as well. We'll just have to wait and see. So anyway, I thought I'll just go for a bit of a wander and show you a few things that I'm pretty chuffed about. So I thought we'd just start down here with this little root pouch wicking garden. As you can see, I got my little secret stash of strawberries. Kira just ran down to ask me a question and she nearly saw them. So there's a couple over the back there you might be able to make out, but don't tell her, please. In this garden, I've also had those honey pod peas up the back. I pulled them out and the soil in those bags there will be revitalized with a bit of fresh compost and some other goodies. And I'm going to grow some potatoes in them. We've got some potatoes chitting in the pantry at the moment. And these two pouches at the front, they had some potatoes in them that fell victim to mites early on. And I had some purslane in there. We were just picking for salads and whatnot. So those guys there are going to be turned into, pardon me, sorry folks. These pouches are going to be turned into carrot pouches, mainly because they're nice and loose, very friable. I put a little bit of extra sand in there. So hopefully they'll be able to grow us some nice carrots. I got some Asti Pusa black carrots from a different supplier this time, so I'm going to have a crack at them. I'm actually going to make up a little way to sow them out to make it easier for folks in square foot gardening. Over in this pouch here, same deal. You can still see some of the purslane that I pulled out the other day but didn't get all of it. Here's just an eggplant that will be coming out, and yeah, do the same thing here. I'll plant this pouch out first and then 2 or 3 weeks later I'll sow some seeds into there, so we get a bit of a progressive sowing thing happening. Up the back here we have this little carrot here that fell over. That's the stalk going down to the carrot down there. Yeah, it couldn't handle the breeze the other day and fell over, so that one will just come out. This pouch here though, I am going to keep this carrot in here. It's decided to flower, and these guys always put out a spectacular flower. I posted a clip a few years ago of one of Kira's that went to flower out the front. They put on an absolutely amazing display. Just down here, nothing else much to talk about except our little banana here has decided to throw up a new leaf, so pretty chuffed about that. I was going to do soil tests and all sorts of things down here, but finances just haven't allowed it at the moment. So what I'm going to do is pretty much we'll just move that tray, dig through a whole heap of veggie scraps, because I don't want to put them in the compost pile over there anymore. Dig through a whole heap of veggie scraps and I'm going to start to condition the ground there, and then these guys will go in. And I've also thinking about splurging and buying some horse manure as well, so that might go in there. And yeah, then we'll pop the bananas in on a slightly elevated bed. Just down here we have a lot of grass that needs to be mowed back. So a couple of volunteer warrigal greens popping up. But it's just around here what I wanted to show you. Just here we have the Queensland arrowroot bed, or Cannaregulus. Now a lot of these greens should have been chopped down a couple of weeks back and thrown into the compost cage over there that I am not going to be adding anything to anymore. So I decided just to leave them be. Sort of glad that I did, because we've got some very stunning flowers have decided to emerge from these guys. They're one of the prettiest flowers I think we've ever grown. We did grow these guys a fair while back when we first had Maya, because our grand plans of making our own arrowroot flower for her and that sort of thing, as she was a toddler, but it didn't come to pass. So we pretty much will leave them go this season, and it looks like a lot of them are about to start throwing up flower spikes. So there's another bud up there that looks like it's going to bloom in the next day or so. Just over here at the blueberries, this is a southern highbush variety, by the way. I always get asked what type it is. It's a southern highbush that does better in warmer climates. As to what variety of southern highbush, I'm sorry I lost the label and I have no idea. But what I wanted to do was show you how well these guys are going fruit-wise. We have had a load of fruit set on here. So I'm going to have to get the fruit fly netting organized very soon to put over the top. They shouldn't hit them until they start to ripen up, but yeah, as you can see, there's a load of flowers on there. The warrigal greens are actually doing rather well down there. This is the next bed we'll be harvesting them from, but yes, very impressed with these guys. Just a little bit of an update for you folks who were rooting for this tomato growing out of a nail hole in a piece of roofing tin in the side of the wicking bed. Yeah, it didn't survive. I think it just got a little bit too heavy down the end here, and it's pretty much well cut itself back there at the nail hole. There is a little bit of fruit on there, but you know, it's probably, by the look of that, one of those small little red cherry tomatoes. Not something we really want to keep growing here. Some beautiful flowers on the cabbage here. So definitely bringing in a few insects, but I think we might be chopping them off soon. I thought I'd give you a quick look at the marigolds. They've decided to flower as well. Doing rather well. I got out here during the week, it was last week now, and managed to do a bit of trimming on those tomatoes. I think I may have even shown it in the last clip. Just around here, this broccoli. This head here is just starting to separate a little bit too far, so she'll be coming off tonight for dinner. This one here will be coming off tonight as well, but one of them will be going in the fridge because we harvested a couple of cauliflowers this week. So we'll try and munch through them first. And we've got a load of side heads coming through on the broccoli. Never pull your broccoli plants out, folks, after you take the first head off, because you're always going to get side shoots. Some years we've actually had more from the side shoots than we have had from the main head. We'll just wait and see what happens with these guys. Just down here on this eggplant, this is the one that I was actually thinking about pulling out, but it can stay here as long as this bed stays. We've got our first little fruit on. Only a couple of days into spring and we've already got some fruit on. They pretty much all started to form during winter though. But we've had some really nice growth on here and some flowers as well. So I have admittedly been giving this a bit of fertilizer, liquid fertilizer, as I walk around with the watering can. So yeah, I like to baby my plants even if they are coming out. I'm over here, this stuff has just gone crazy. The bees are a little bit quiet today. The next big plan down here is to remove that compost heap because I want to put just to one side there, pretty much or just about there, I want to put my first wicking bed for the ginger. I've got some sitting in a tray of water and it really does need to go out, so that's my first job once I make it back out here to the patch. So, oh, and our mango tree. I don't think I've posted a photo this year. I did take one. Our mango tree has bloomed. They've got a really stunning small little blossom on a flower head that has many, many, many flowers on them if you're not familiar with mangoes. Now, out of all those flowers, there's potentially hundreds of mangoes on a flower head, but you'll generally only get one or two. It's a little bit early to give you a look at the fruit setting, but yeah, hopefully we'll get a half decent crop this year. Mind you, the mango tree isn't chook powered anymore, so it's just relying on waste from the aquaponics now to keep it fed up. Just down here we harvested the first of the volunteer lettuces from the rocks, and not much has gone on with the aquaponics at all. Haven't been out here other than to harvest bits and pieces. Oh, except for overflowing the sump. I did a top up the other day and I overflowed the sump a fair bit. Didn't affect the nitrate levels, but yeah, still not a good thing to be wasting water. So our Tahitian lime tree is doing well too, starting to put on a few new bits of growth. And as you can see, there's a fair few little fruit around the place. Some have actually put on a fairly decent amount of size. I posted a very quick update clip on this one a while back, I think. And we've still got some nice full-size fruit on there. But just look at all the small little fruit. If they all stick, we're going to be swimming in these guys very, very soon. And around here, there's some nice-sized ones as well. They're coming on. So mighty chuffed with this Tahitian lime, and I'm glad I fed it up when I did. As you can see, the new growth is coming through fine and a lot of the deficiency is slowly fading from the other leaves. And just while we were here, I thought I'd show you this Queensland arrowroot I just spotted. This one here has gone to bloom as well, although she's laying down. Couldn't quite take the weight, so it'd be interesting to see if we actually get any seeds form on these guys. Just up here in this small wicking bed next to Piggly. We've got some more strawberries coming on. The girls have seen these ones, but I think I can beat them out. I'd say they'll be ready in the next couple of days. And the Werikawai tomato is booming in here. This is the one I rescued from a bed out the back. Just one more thing I want to show you is these guys. I've got to sneak them past the girls. Bianca and I are going to have them after dinner. This tree here is absolutely loaded with fruit and nice size ones too. So definitely one of our favorite trees to grow here, the dwarf mulberry. I really can't wait to get this one in the ground just to see what she can do for us. Well, actually, there's one more thing. Just in this top root pouch garden, when I do the tomatoes, I'll be coming up and trimming these guys as well. I need to give these guys a bit of a snip. These are the sunshine chilies, type of Argy Amarillo. They need to be just pruned back a bit just so they grow a nice thick base. Little Thai basil down here is struggling. There's two in there that have taken, actually three, sorry. There's a couple behind the tomato there. Not sure what sort of tomato is, but it's not going to make it. This eggplant is doing really well. This is the one we're going to be keeping. And if I can get down in here, we've got some babies on there. One there, another one just over there. But what I wanted to show you was my banana has finally, I think, decided that it does like its new home. And it sent out a new leaf. So hopefully, yeah, we might end up getting a bunch of fruit off this. I posted a clip about transplanting these guys out. Hopefully they're going to do better in there than the last ones. A little bit concerned about this one here. This one here is the Ducasse, and it doesn't have any new leaf spikes whatsoever, so a little bit concerned about that one. Might just go grab my basket and knife and we'll start harvesting. So my phone battery died on me before I got to harvest the broccoli, and we also grabbed a couple of carrots from the back stairs there. I did go up and grab this camera though, and I toddled off out the front and harvested a nice handful of the green beans from the little bushes in the front wicking gardens, and also took off a couple of nice heads of cauliflower from the wicking bed out the front. The cauliflower, we're pretty much all just going to be popping that in the fridge. We might give the purple one to mum and dad. I've still got a nice large orangish sort of cauliflower head from the colour pack that I harvested during the week, so we'll have to use that one up first, but the broccoli will definitely go down a treat tonight. So I do hope you've enjoyed a little bit of a look at the backyard. I did show a few things that I didn't get to in the last clip, so I hope you enjoyed that. If you do like these sort of clips and you want to see more, you can hit that little subscribe button, and YouTube will send you an email whenever we upload a little clip on our backyard farm. It could be a wanderer through the patch or having a look at the aquaponics, you never know. Hopefully next weekend though, there will be a harvest clip on the purple Congo potatoes, and maybe the sweet potatoes out the front as well. So fingers crossed we'll get to that. I do hope everyone is well and happy, and I will catch you next clip. Cheers folks. So it's the next morning and I thought I'd show you how much rain we got. Round about 34-35 mil by the look of it. Online they said we had 33.8, so not a bad drop at all. Don't think I'll have to worry about topping up the wicking beds at all today. And I saw something else down here I thought I'd just share with you. Looks like we have another pumpkin. Little female flower. I found this one during the week when I kicked it, hanging out some clothes, so I didn't show this one through the clip, but it looks like we're going to get another season out of this volunteer pumpkin that's growing in that first bed. So I will leave it there. Cheers, folks. Have a great one.